Hello folks, welcome back to another episode of Firewood Doctor. We got the G372XP warming up. It's getting cold, the sun is behind the building, so now it's shaded. It was 15, 14 degrees last night. It got just above freezing today, so it's cold in the shade now. Whew. Okay, I'm working on the tree service wood again. I'm gonna see how much I can get cut before it gets dark, because I'm almost out of gas in the can. I don't like to let the gas age too long, so saw should be warmed up, and let's get cutting. Shut it off for a minute, because that thing has no fuel range. It doesn't have the cutting time that a regular saw would have, so gotta kind of get that lump out of there. Watch the idle time on it. Here we go. A little chunk of wood, hold that in place. I haven't done one of these for a while where I'm doing it real time and no hyperlapse. Oh. chips are coming off of that. Brand new Hypa saw chain, full chisel. Out of the way. Would help to cut through that log. Yeah, a lot of people wonder, why do some people do videos like this where they just do all the work and no hyperlapse, you know, and some talking? Well, it's just, this style of video for this one just feels right to me. And I gotta cut through that, finish cut through that. This, I think, is long cut. Well, it might be about right. It might be 18 inch. Yeah, this one's that 17 inch range. That's what you get for not precisely marking stuff. That one, up and over, and no up and over. Get it back on its side here. I don't feel like blowing my back out today. You're not gonna see any He-Man heroics today. If you don't know who He-Man is, brush up in your 80s anime or cartoons. Alright, a little more room to work with. Oh, sure, and it falls down between the log piles all the way the wrong way. Alright, let's continue. I know it's four stroke a little bit, but it was running too red, too lean last time I ran it, so I tested it up.
Oh.
to stack up more so I'm not tripping over stuff. Finish getting it stacked up, and then show you what I got cut up. I'll tell you more about this new pickeroon or hookeroon, whatever you want to call it, in a later video. It's that my other one broke, so. Boy, this is a dream to use compared to the other one. Oh, it's getting cold. So we got from that one that's turned sideways. I did not cut that one this time. That was from last time. And that row all the way down to here. Got these two rows done. So that's quite a bit. I think I got my brightness turned up too high. I don't know. I'll check my camera settings later, but yeah. Not a bad day of work since I did a lot of other stuff. Burning debris, listing ads, you know, wood up for sale and ads. And so I got at least two face cord out of that tank of fuel. Wood down 2.5. It might be pushing 2.5 face cords, but it would be 2.5 to 3 face cords if it had a bigger tank, because that tank is a little smaller than the OEM ones. I think they do that on purpose to get around some of the patents. They can't say it's an exact copy. So, but man, that new Hypochain was throwing a serious amount of chips. I mean, a serious amount. I mean, it was throwing chips past that other burn pile there. So, well, that's it, folks. I got a little tidying up to do, raking the coals of the debris fire, so I can get out of here. So, till next time, folks, take care, get out there, do something, have fun doing it.